everyone, and welcome to Connolly Chapel of the Sacred Heart here at DeSales University. My name is Ryan Mullaney. I'm the Director of Chorale Activities here, and we're delighted to be with you this evening and to share music with you all over the world, hopefully. And it's just been a joy to work through this tumultuous year with these wonderful people who you see or will see here shortly before you. I'm going to ask them to stand up and get into their places while I continue talking. You know, it's interesting, the program that you see tonight never would have happened in the iteration that, or that you're going to hear rather, never would have happened in the iteration that it is. You don't have a program. I'm going to be giving you oral program notes throughout the evening. And in the YouTube stream chat, the text of the pieces are going to be dropped in as well as the title of the pieces, so you'll be able to follow. It's interesting, this journey through a pandemic, and we all have stories to tell in this. So what I've done this evening is I've asked the students to reflect on the pieces and to write a word or words at the beginning of the pieces that we're going to sing tonight. And if they feel so moved at the beginning of the piece, I'm going to leave a moment of silence for them to speak what it means to them, whether it was something that was really personal, or whether it was a group moment, or whether it was a struggle of theirs, or whether it was a great joy to experience this. It's hard to kind of put this hodgepodge program together, but if we look closely, we'll be able to see some common threads throughout. The first two pieces that we're going to sing for you this evening, Mendelssohn's Verleihung's Frieden, a wonderful psalm setting, followed by Palestrina's Sicut Cervus.
Trusting.
are about all creatures, and then birds made of clay. Joyful.
Green.
Lively.
Merry.
Dashing.
Grand.
Majestic.
Crazy. Bouncy. Triumphant.
Amen.
So you're probably wondering, actually, how this program fits together, and it kind of doesn't. This is sort of a hodgepodge of things that we've been putting together for the last year. And, you know, COVID, it's been a challenge. And some of the things we've been working on for a year, some of them we haven't finished, some of them we didn't get to finish. And so the program is constantly evolving. But frankly, it kind of has a vibe of one of those good old programs, choral programs, where we put a lot of things together on and just a mishmash of things, and we get a variety show kind of thing. But I would say that it's really easy to find threads in things when we look carefully. Just listen to the words that the students are saying tonight. We're telling our story amidst this cloth woven together, maybe patchwork as it is. But I do think we can find some commonality in these pieces. Hope and safety, life-giving streams, many creatures, birds of play. This next set, I should say that the two pieces you heard before that, John Bennett's All Creatures Now, wonderful piece, challenging piece for us, those equal soprano parts. And then a setting by Richard Shepherd, The Birds. It's just a wonderful setting. The next set that we're going to go to, She Is. When I long for a time, and of course, seeking. The first piece you're going to hear grouped together is John Clement's Flower of Beauty, talking about a lovely spring evening, wandering with one's love. The next piece is a sort of angular kind of reflection. I long for a time for when I was unhappy and remember it fondly because I got beyond that. Pretty powerful in this day and age. And then after that, we get to a piece that sort of sums up the essence of our term. Eric William Barnum's Spirit Seeking Light and Beauty. This piece has been a labor of love for us. It's been a real challenge. And I think in so many ways, it really pulls us together, and I'm happy to sing it for you, have us sing it for you this evening. The poetry is by Janet Erskine Stewart, and she's a religious a nun of the Sacred Heart of Jesus, and being that we're in Connolly Chapel of the Sacred Heart, it seems even more appropriate this evening, and it really gets at the heart of the matter, I think. Seeking, spirit seeking light and beauty out of this tumultuous time. I think that's it.
Oh.
I mentioned before, despite the challenges, we really do know we're the lucky ones that get to sing and get to do this year. And even though we've been belly aching along the way, I think, in some ways with the COVID protocols and things we couldn't actually do. And one of those things was last year, Schola Cantorum started doing a penitential procession for Lent. And if you could see the aisle here in Connolly Chapel, if we were standing in the aisle and facing each other, it would not provide for adequate social distancing. So we didn't get to do that program this year, but we were working on some motets for it. We're going to listen, sing for you two motets, Miserere Mei Domine by Orlando Di Lasso, and then Percy Whitlock's O Living Bread, Who Once Did.
Thank you.
outset of the evening. But first, we have some business to do. I want to acknowledge some people. First of all, I want to say a big thank you to our administration, Father Jim, Brother Dan, those who helped make this happen curricularly. This is such a joy and a blessing to have these students integrate in class as often as we do during the week. And it's really been a pleasure, and it's been great to have the tools to be able to do that, so thank you. To Jerry Joyce, our COVID czar, who's done a great job of keeping us safe. The entire campus community, we could not have done it without that kind of leadership from the top on down. So to everybody who contributed to the COVID precautions on campus, thank you. University marketing, Carolyn Steigelman, Kristen Lobenslager, Tim Cox, Tom McNamara, the whole team, they've been wonderful to work with. Thank them. Carmen Chickalese, who's in the booth in the back dealing with the live stream and also solved a problem early on in the evening. So thank you, Carmen, you're the man. We really appreciate it. The always steady, always funny Bill Holmes, our audio engineer, talented guy. We love him. We love working with him. We're so happy that he's here running the audio tonight. To our DeSales University Choir Executive Committee, our president, Genevieve O'Connor, sitting over here, who you can't see, I'm sure. Former choir manager, Joe Fremont. Current choir managers, Nate Gordon and Ren Garancher. And Shay Elliott is somewhere, our Chorale library. Thank you guys for having that. Lastly, for this guy here, Dr. Dennis Marley, who had a vision for this program, and even despite the COVID challenges, we're seeing it through. And I couldn't do it without your support. None of us could, so thank you. Really, it means a lot. Last but not least, we need to recognize some important people who are moving on in the world. Our seniors. Going on to bigger and better things, leaving the sales, but leaving in a better place for having been here. If you can see in the camera shots tonight, seniors have red carnation on, so you can hopefully identify them. I know it's a little dark in here, and the camera doesn't pick up everything, but we're going to miss you terribly. Those people, Adrian Anatolio, who is our soloist coming up for MLK, Helen Cow, Kevin Doe, Joe Fremont, Raymond Porcos, Grace Benitez, and Carla Quintanilla. Guys, thank you so much for what you have done in bringing great music to this choral program. Also, the seniors didn't get a shout out last year, so we got to shout the 2020 seniors out. I already saw that Molly Carnish is watching at home. Molly Carnish, Dave Metz, Tyler Sarge, Izzy Fernandez, and Adam Leferovich. We miss you guys. We're going to have you come back and sing with us really soon. To close out this evening, another piece from the penitential procession that we didn't get to do leads into two other chorale pieces that we're going to do tonight. Ecce quomodo moritur, or Ecce quomodo moritur, of Jacobus Gallus. Then we'll go into You Choose MLK, as a tribute to Martin Luther King, of U2, and arranged by Bob Chilcutt. And then fittingly, After It Rains on Him and Us, we'll go to Charles Albert Tinley's The Storm is Passing Over. Before we start, though, I want to draw a correlation between the past music that we're hearing in the past tonight and the music of the present and today. I'm going to read you the poetry of the thing we're going to sing next, and we're going to sing these three things without interruption. This is Ecce quomodo moritur. How fitting these things tie together. Lo, the righteous perisheth, and no man layeth to heart. And righteous men are taken away, none considering it. The righteous is taken from that which is evil, and his memory shall be in peace. His tabernacle is in peace, and his dwelling place in Zion, and his memory shall be in peace.
And
Schola.